Good morning, dear students. I, Mr. Prateek Hemrajani, will be teaching you mathematics online. And on behalf of the entire SJC family, I would like to congratulate each one of you for making up to this new upgraded class. Before we start with the very first chapter in this academic session, I would like to recap few points that are very important according to me and where children misunderstand those terms and make a lot of errors in maths. First one is sum. And sum means addition. But children, they get confused sum with multiplication. So don't get confused. Sum means addition. And the symbol for sum is plus. Second one is difference. D-I-F-F-E-R-E-N-C-E. Difference basically means subtraction and the symbol is minus. Children basically get confused difference with division and that's wrong. Difference basically means subtraction. The third term is product. That means multiplication. And the symbol is cross. Fourth term is quotient, which means division. And the symbol is this. The first chapter that we'll be dealing is number system. Right? As you all can see, the name is made up of two words, number and system. So first of all, we will see what is a number and what is a system. A number is basically a word or a symbol that indicates a quantity. While system is a set of rules for organizing something. So as a whole, what is a number system? It defines a set of values that indicate a quantity, right, with the help of symbol and word, right? So all together when we join these two, we'll be getting, it defines a set of values that indicate a quantity. To understand number system in a much better way, we can compare it with a computer system, which contains various modules clubbed up together, like mouse, keyboard, CPU, monitor, like they are all clubbed up together and it is termed as a computer system. In the same way, a number system consists of various numbers that are clubbed up and then it forms what is called as number system. We'll start with the very first and basic numbers that are taught to us when we were small. Like we started learning about numbers right from class prep and we started with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, right? So these numbers are called counting numbers. What are these called? They are called counting numbers and in mathematical terms they are termed as natural numbers, right? They are denoted by capital N. right? So natural numbers are denoted by capital N and they are all positive in nature. They start with 1, right? If we add 0 to natural number, we get whole numbers and they are represented by capital W, right? Whole numbers, right? Next set of numbers that we learn about is integers, and integers are represented by capital I or capital Z. Now what are integers? Integers are positive or negative natural numbers including 0, where 0 is neutral, right? Next set of numbers that we will talk about is rational numbers, and they are represented by capital Q. Right? Now the thing is, what are rational numbers? Rational numbers are those numbers which can be expressed in form of ratios, right? Or we can say in term of a fraction, where the numerator and denominator both should be integers and the denominator should not be equal to 0, right? Next set of numbers that we will be studying about is irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are those numbers which cannot be expressed as simple fractions, right? And when we join rational and irrational numbers both, we get real numbers. And real numbers are represented by capital R, right? We have one more set of numbers that are in parallel with real numbers and that are called imaginary numbers, whose value is under root minus 1. This we will be studying in class 11th and 12th, right? At this level of yours, we have to deal with rational numbers, integers, whole numbers and natural numbers. And in this chapter, we have to primarily deal with whole numbers, right? All these numbers together, they constitute number system, right? Now children, we will be dealing with Hindu Arabic system of writing numbers. In Hindu Arabic system of writing numbers, we have got 10 symbols, namely 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. And each symbol is termed as a digit, or each symbol is known as a digit. And when a group of digits denote a number, they are all together termed as a numeral. What do I mean to say? Like suppose if I club up 1, 2, 1, 3. So these are three different digits. When they are clubbed up together, there is no comma in between. So all together it will be termed as a numeral. Right? Let us now understand how we can express numbers. Right? Numbers can be expressed in two ways. First, by writing them in form of figures or by writing them in words. What do I mean by writing them in figures? Like suppose we take the number 56. So we write 56 like this in terms of figures. And in term of words, we write it as 56. Right? This way, that is the way I have represented it on the left side, is termed as notation. This is termed as notation. And when we express the number in terms of words, we term it as numeration. Don't get puzzled up, because notation and numeration, both you have studied in your previous classes by the name of numeral and number names. That means the other name for numeration is number name or simply words. For notation, we can use numeral or figures. Right? I hope this much concept is clear. To understand numbers in a much better way, now we will start with place value chart. In place value chart, it has got two parts. The first part, that is the topmost part, is termed as periods, and the second part is termed as places. We start filling the periods and places from extreme right corner. The first period is our ones period, followed by thousands period, then we have lakhs period, then we have crores period. In ones period, we have ones, tens, hundred. In thousand, we have thousand, 10,000. In lakhs, we have lakh, 10 lakh. In crores, we have crore and 10 crore. Right? To understand this in a much better way, let us take one example. Suppose we have got one number, say 21,562. We'll start filling the digits of this particular number from right to left, and one digit at a time. First, the extreme right number is 2, so 2 will come under 1's place, 6 will come under 10's place, 5 will come under 100's place, 1 will come under 1000's place, 2 will come under 10,000's place. Right? Suppose if I ask you what is the place value of 5 in this, so what we need to do is we just have to see where this 5 is lying in the place value chart. 5 is lying under 100's place, so the place value of 5 will be 500. Right? There is one more term that is similar to place value, and that is called face value. And the children get confused between place value and face value. So let us understand the basic difference between face value and place value. Right? See, face value, to understand this term, you can consider your own face. Like when you are at home, when you are in school, or when you go to play games somewhere, your face remains same. In the same way, in face value, the value of the digit itself will be the face value. That means face value represents value of the digit itself. Like suppose if I take 1, so the face value of 1 will remain 1, no matter at which place it is coming. Right? In the same way, when we talk about 6, so 6, the face value of 6 will remain 6, no matter at which place it is lying. Right? But when we talk about place value, the place value changes. Just like you can take my example, when I'm at home, I'm treated as a son. When I'm school, I'm treated as a teacher. When I'm at a sports complex, I will be treated as a sports person. Right? So that means place value varies according to the place. Right? Suppose we take, if you have to consider, suppose we need to find out the place value of 1. So there are two ways to find this place value, right? First one, that is the easiest one. We have to find the place value of 1. So you write 1. After 1, how many digits are there? 1, 2 and 3. So add 3 zeros. Right? So the place value of 1 will be 1000. Right? This is one way. Other way, you apply the formula. Place value is equal to face value into value of the place. Right? Now the face value of 1 is 1 into value of the place. What is value of the place? 1000. So 1 into 1000, you will get 1000. So any of the two ways you can choose to calculate place value. The next topic that we'll be covering is expanded form. To understand expanded form in a much easier way, we can take the example of this rubber band. Suppose if you stretch the rubber band, you all can see the length of the rubber band got expanded, got increased, right? In the same way, when you talk about expanded form of numbers, suppose we take the example of 15,734. So what we do in expanded form of numbers, we take out the value, the place value of each digit, either from right side, either from left side, it's up to you, right? We take the place value of each digit and then we add the place values. I repeat, then we add the place values. The very first number on the extreme left is 1. So what is the place value of 1? After 1, you have got 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers, 4 digits. We'll have 4 zeros here, right? Then plus, next number is 5. Place value of 5 is 1, 2, 3. We'll add 3 zeros here. Plus, next number is 7. After 7, there are 2 digits. So we'll add 2 zeros. Next is 3. The place value of 3 is 13 this, and then the last one, that is 4. Right? So this is the way we write expanded form. In exam, when the question is there of expanded form, children basically, in place of addition, they put multiplication sign, and there they go wrong. So don't do this mistake. This is the easiest way that you all can learn expanded form. In your book, one more method is given that says that first you take out the face value, then multiply by the place at which the digit is, and then add. Ultimately, you will be getting the same answer. And in exam, you can follow any of the two methods, whichever you find it easier, right? To understand the topic in a much better way, we'll try to solve this question, which says we have to represent this particular number on a place value chart. And then we have to write this notation and numeration as well, right? To write this on a place value chart, let us first form the place value chart. We have got ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh and 10 lakh. I'm not mentioning the periods, I've just mentioned the places, right? We'll start filling this particular number starting from right to left. The first number that is 0 will come under 1's place, then 1 will come under 10's place, followed by 2, 1, 3, 5 and 2. So in this way we have represented our number on a place value chart, and it depends on you whether you want to mention the periods or not. But this much will do, right? Second part of the question says, write the notation. Notation basically means writing the numbers. But one thing we need to understand, after every period, while we are writing the numbers in notation form, we have to put commas. We have to put commas, right? This is one period, so comma. This is another period, comma, followed by this, right? So we have to make one thing very clear while writing in notation form. The number should be written with the help of commas, and commas separate different periods in the number itself, right? Next thing that we need to do in this is numeration. Numeration means writing in words or number names, right? While writing number names, we'll start with the very first period on the extreme left side. This is our lakh periods. We'll write 25,31,000 210. Always remember one thing, children, while writing number names, don't put any commas in between the periods. It is only necessary to put commas during notation, not in numeration. First error that students do. Second thing, while writing number names, don't add any S, like lakhs, thousands, hundreds, that's wrong, right? No need to add any S. And you can add AND and at the end if you wish. Else, this will also do. Just write in this way.